there is a repo rate is reduced from 6 to 5.5%. Okay, we can clap hands. What is that? What is it matter? Cash reserve ratio has been reduced from 5.5% to 5%. See, these type of bank reforms, these type of policy reforms, and various other new things that can give us a clear idea that something is happening. But knowledge or information asymmetry is, instead of naming the problem, naming the solution, dealing with the process, rather than what is the exact point, we want only three things. What is my personal role? What is the practical solution? What is the immediate step that has been taken? Or that has to be taken place? So this is what we have to understand in it. And there are six major steps that have been taken by India, and I want to just present in a small version view what are the steps taken by India. Number one, each and every country at the time of this type of decision, they will take only common steps. Common steps which are suitable to most of the places. Number one is modification of fiscal and monetary policies. A study of wholesale price index and consumer index. Then continuous flow of low interest credit facilities to small and medium enterprises so as to facilitate their existence, survival, growth, expansion, etc. That is also being opened now. The fourth thing is increase in expenditure by which there will be more public demand so that we can cause new credits. That is number four. Number five, to create an initiative with two major quietly unqualified sectors. One is the mutual bond sector of the society. Second is non-banking financials. So they have to address that. They have been doing that. Sixth is the very wonderful thing which has not been mentioned at all. It is to keep a meticulous watch on market manipulators and institutional speculators in the stock industry. That should be done. That is by not coming to loss and everything is like everybody becomes Kuchela, contributing somebody to become Kuchela is not a stock market. And this type of manipulation in market as well as these institutional speculations should be watched. These are the six norms given. And considering the global causes for recession, somebody has to, if you see any article or any speech, if India is mentioned 10 times, 100 times there will be mentioned the name of US. In any article, even dealing with Indian economy, 100 times the US will be there. Once a person gave an article about economic crisis and development, in which he has written, he has just given to me for appraisal or some corrections to me. He has made a word. Now it is time to think of US. He has made a letter in characters. Just he made a small correction. I just crossed it and wrote the same in small letters. We have to think of US as now. So what is the reason for why they are talking about US? Because of three reasons. Number one, dependency. $50 billion industry of our IT resources and revenue is from US. Apart from that, we are having industrial sector and non-US dependent sectors are there. Agrarian sector of 60% is there, but still it is there. And this GDP of US, it contributes 1/3 of the global GDP. 1/3 of the global GDP, that is the reason. And third thing, due to its unprogressive progress, that it has pseudo-secularized the society by means of its advertisement, by means of the exposure. Everybody is having a US imitation, or like Euro media, they are having US media. Imitation of the model, imitation of their success, and more willing to be very much absorbed into the US consciousness. It is that in the society. They are adding US in all possible means wherever it is possible. The main four factors that are dealing with this recession problem is, number one is credit paradise. You see, somebody told in a seminar, if you repay the credit, you will collapse. If you don't repay it, the company will collapse. So credit without ability to repay, without proper usage and multiplication, if it is got and it gets accumulated or multiplied, that accumulated credit cannot be paid back. As told earlier, you will collapse if you pay it, and atomic will, like, you know, if you demonstrate the sale, the company will collapse. So this type of credit aspiration or the credit paradise. See, whenever you purchase something, that should be a reasonable way of necessity, utility and ability. You have no need for that, you have no ability for that, you don't have the capability to purchase that, in spite of which if you are thinking about the usage of something, then it is a mere temptation drive. You cannot have any proper use at all. So that is known as the credit paradise. And the second thing is subprime mortgaging. Today they have mentioned about subprime mortgaging. How initially subprime mortgaging will come, it will emerge in a single day without support of any political sponsorship or high-end dealing. After getting it as a cumulative and composite effect, after several years, only it will emerge in a very big manifested way of magnificence, it will come on one day. So this subprime mortgaging is not exempted in India. Somebody told, do you think independence, we have discussed about non-US possibilities of economic growth in India that was a similar today, to deal with rest of African countries, to encross more defects and more structural construction in inter-domesticated marketing facilities, personal boosting, to create inner demand more, all of these innumerable ways are there to facilitate the inner economy of our nation. And in India, lack of facilities have been done. 35,000 crores immediately after the recession, 35,000 crores it was released for bailing out, for the recessional emancipation of the nation, 35,000 crores have been given. And in which 4,000 crores have been handed over to the National Housing Bank for promoting housing. But the problem is, where is the land? How to acquire the land? There is land mafia, there is problem with land acquisition, construction, other things. That is the problem. One. Number 2,400, textile is the most vulnerable area of industry that has been affected. Recession, 1,400 crores have been given as grant. But the Apparel Export Promotion Council chairman, he gave a letter. Sir, this 1,400 crores, what you are giving, what you are thinking as a grant, is the arrears which you have been asking for several decades, so it cannot be used for any promotion work. So that is the nature here. So the grant that has been given has become the arrears. Number three, for developing infrastructure management, the Indian infrastructure finance corporation, it has given some sort of allowance to develop 14,000 crores of its structure or economical stability through tax-free bonds. Tax-exempted bonds for 14,000 crores was allowed to the infrastructure financing corporation to realize, to release, and to respond to the society by infrastructure promotion. And this is also not yours too, because who is going to go inside and what are the other paraphernalia required for this infrastructure maintenance? That is also not you. Number four, 2% of interest rate subsidy is given to all exports. Export interest rate subsidy is given by 2%, whereas the deficit in export is $50 billion. And for all small positions, that is small and medium enterprises, they are given loan facilities for 50 lakhs to 1 crore. But it is like plucking the teeth and giving the ornament. There are no opportunities in the society for moving the products. There are no proper labor consciousness in the society. Internalization, but the loan availability is there. But promotion into some other third quarter or the fourth quarter where they can be down seen. At that time, this facility is very useful. So, these are the various things. Even Kamal Nath later he announced 325 crores of one package for textile, jewelry, gems, and leather. He announced a second package. But this thing is comparably very, very infinitesimal to the top. This is approximately $7.3 billion. Whereas $800 billion is offered for bailout by US economy, and China has released $580 billion. Considering with that thing, it is simply nothing, and it is very small, piecemeal or immediate consideration which has been given to us, by which we have to provoke up. So this is the question of the present economic society. And we should understand something, what is crisis? Somebody told in defining crisis, that somebody may be me also, I don't remember. But the crisis